Hey everyone, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. I welcome you all in this video. As you would know that the current affairs that I discuss in this video are useful for your RBI SEBI NABARD and banking examinations at the level of PU. So on that note, if you're a newcomer here, then guys, do not forget to subscribe to our channel and hit the bell notification. And if you're an old watcher and still have not subscribed, then please subscribe and hit the bell notification. This is the Telegram group which you can join to get your queries resolved by directly connecting with your mentors. Also, here we provide you with free quizzes. So if you want to enjoy those quizzes, then you can join this group by the link given in the description below. This is the 2022 course, guys. Here you will get PDFs, videos and mocks along with your mock interview preparation. So we conduct mock interviews so that you can be prepared for your final interviews. And this is the booklet that you will get if you enroll in this course. Right now, we are running a 30% discount on this course, but if you want to avail that discount, you have to use RBI 30 coupon code. And this is the number that you can use to call us if you have any query related to the course or related to the examination. So that was all. Now let's begin this video. How many total indicators were used in the Performance Grading Index 2019 to 20? First of all, this index was released by Ministry of Education. And the purpose of this index is to assess the performance of various states and union territories in the field of school education. Now, what are the details of this index that we will discuss a little later, but let's first focus on the indicators that have been used to assess the states and union territories in India. So out of these options, the right answer here is option A. 70 indicators were used. Now let us discuss this index in detail. First of all, the Department of School Education and Literacy under the Ministry of Education has released this index. So remember the department as well. And as I have told you that this is going to assess the performance of states in terms of school education. Now, this index has divided the parameters or the indicators on which the states and union territories are going to be assessed into categories. So first of all, we have two categories and then the domains are there. So this is the smart art that I have prepared so that you can easily understand the structure of this index, because questions from the structures, parameters and indicators have been asked in the examination previously as well. Therefore, it is important for you to memorize this. So first of all, we have category in this index. The categories are two. First is outcome category and second is governance and management. Now under this outcome categories, you have four domains. First is learning outcome and quality. Second is access. Third is infrastructure facility. And the fourth is equity. So these are the domains. And in the second category, there is only one domain, governance processes. So these are the different domains. And the 70 indicators have been divided into these domains only. And on the basis of those indicators, these states and union territories have been run. I hope that there is nothing much that you cannot understand here. The domains are easy because they are focusing on the learning outcome. Every domain is focusing on one or the other dimension related to the school education. So from that point of view, if you remember this entire smart art, it will help you in keeping it in your mind for a later period of time. Okay, for example, the first domain is learning outcome and quality. How much the schools are focusing on providing the qualitative education so that learning outcome can be improved. Second is access. How much access is the school providing to the children, or the children, how much access the children have to the school. Third is infrastructure and facilities. This is simple. And fourth is equity. How much equality is being provided in the school in terms of education. And here we have governance processes, how the school is governing its processes. So these are the domains, and each and every domain is catering to one or the other needs of the school education. So I hope this helps you in memorizing this smart art better. And remember, the total number of indicators is 70. Okay, now let us understand the structure of scoring. First of all, why are we discussing all these mechanisms of this index? The reason behind this is that it has been released by Ministry of Education, and because it is an indigenous index, I would say, therefore it is very important for us to understand its structure as well. Even if you cover any international index, you still cover the parameters and indicators. And here it is an Indian index, and there are high chances that question can come up on these mechanisms as well. Okay, so we have the structure of scoring. Here you can see this color coded score range. So the highest score range is 901 to 950. Then we have 851 to 900, 801 to 850. So these are the different color codes. And with each color code, the performance of state varies. For example, if a state has been put in this category, then it means that it is the best performer in this index. I hope that this much is clear to you. Now, the second point of importance here is that Ladakh has been scored for the first time in this index. So this is very obvious because Ladakh gained its sovereignty sometime back only. It became a union territory only. So this would be the first time that Ladakh is being judged in this index. So I hope that this much is clear to you. I'm moving forward towards the performance of states and union territories. So best performing states are Chandigarh, Andaman and Nicobar, Punjab, Kerala, Tamil Nadu. So we have two union territories and three states. Remember this as well. Two union territories and three states are there in the best performers. And in case of worst performers, so we have Ladakh and Meghalaya. The third point here is that most states and union territories have improved their performance in comparison to the previous year, that is 2019 to 2020. This is the score table for the states and union territories. So as you can see that the highest score level is 951-2000, which has not been scored by any state. So here, no state has achieved this much score. Now the second best category is 901-950 score that has been achieved by Andaman Nicobar, Chandigarh, Kerala, Punjab and Tamil Nadu. Remember, three states, two union territories, because this can also be asked in your exam. Then we have the third category, level 3, 851 to 900. Here we have a total number of 7 states. Then level 4, mein, there are 8 number of states along with the union territories. So remember the total number of states and union territories falling into each category, each group. Okay. The next is level 5th. Here we have 8. Again, level 6, mein, there are 4 states. So this is the slide which indicates the poor performance of different states and UTs. So in the level 7, Arunachal Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Nagaland, Meghalaya is in level 8 and Ladakh is at the bottom of this index at level 10. So the top 5 worst performing states are right in front of you. Arunachal Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Nagaland, Meghalaya, Ladakh. So these are the 5 worst performers. 5 best performers and 5 worst performers are important for you to remember. Ladakh is because it has not gained much attention till now. Therefore, Ladakh is there in the bottom. So guys, that was all about this performance grading index. I hope that you have not faced any difficulty in understanding this index. But still, if you are facing any kind of problem in understanding, then you can ask me in the comment section or on the Telegram. So that was all about this question. Now we are moving on to the next question, which is again very important, particularly for the NABARD students. What is the expense sharing ratio between center and state in the SEED Miniket program respectively? So we have different percentages, different ratios of this SEED Miniket program. The right answer here is option D, 100:0. It refers to 100% funding by the central government. That means that this program is completely sponsored by the central government. Now, what is this program? This SEED Miniket program is basically the program to provide seeds, to distribute these SEED Miniket. And in those SEED Miniket, various varieties of quality seeds are there so that the qualitative seeds can be sown and seed replacement ratio can be increased in India. Now, what is this seed replacement ratio? Seed replacement ratio is the ratio or is the percentage of the qualitative seeds which have been sown in the ground in comparison to the total cultivated area. So how much or how many qualitative seeds we have sown in one area in comparison to the total area, that refers to the seed replacement ratio. So in order to increase this seed replacement ratio in India, this SEED Miniket program was launched earlier by the Ministry of Agriculture, and for this year 2021, this program has been recently launched by distributing the SEED Minikets among the farmers. So I hope that this much is clear to you guys. Now remember that the entire funding for this program is done under the National Food Security Program. National Food Security Program. So this is the program under which this entire SEED Miniket program is being carried out by the government of India. So I hope this much is clear to you. Now remember that the seed distribution is done by three agencies. And what are these three agencies? First is NAFED, National Seed Corporation, Gujarat State Seed Corporation. So these are the three agencies that are distributing the mini kits to the farmers. So I hope that this much is clear to you guys. And now I am moving on to the next question. What is the total food grain production estimate for 2021 as per the third advance estimate of principal crops for 2020 to 2021? So again, a question important for the NABARD students. But guys, those who are appearing for RBI and SEBI, do not ignore this question, because such kind of questions are asked in your RBI and SEBI examinations as well, because here the total food grain estimate has been asked from you. So this is a very probable question that can come up in your examination. So coming back to this question, we have all the amounts here. Out of these quantities, the right answer is option D. 305.44 million tons is the estimated food grain production for the 2020 to 2021, and remember that this is going to be the record production in India. So I hope that this much is clear to you. Now this is the table. This is the table of food production estimates. Okay. So first we have total food grains, then rice, wheat, nutri, coarse seeds, cereals, maize, pulses, tur, gram, oil seeds, and remember groundnut, soybean, rapeseed and mustard comes under the category of oil seeds. Therefore, the total production of oil seed is important. Now, also remember this thing that in the month of February this year only, the government of India set the target for mustard production at around 10 million tons. Now here the estimate is also around 9.99 million tons. So this is very approximate. Remember that 10 million tons target was set up for 2020 to 2021, and this estimate is also for 2020 to 2021. So here we can say that the government has achieved its target. Then we have sugarcane, cotton, jute and maize. So this is the table which elaborates the crops as well as their production estimate. And remember guys, this is important for you to remember. Particularly I'm saying that the NABARD student should not dare to ignore this table even for a single crop. Okay, because this is the third advance estimate for the food production for 2020 to 2021, and all these crops are principal crops. Okay, so that was all. Now we have the next question. Who has been appointed as the president of FINA? First of all, what is this FINA? FINA is the International Swimming Federation that governs this sport of swimming. Now, Hussein Al Musallam has been appointed as the president of FINA for the year 2021 to 2025. Remember that this person, Sam Ramaswamy, he is from South Africa and he has become the first vice president of FINA. Okay, so this reminds me that I have forgotten to tell you that this Hussein Al Musallam belongs to Kuwait. Remember their nationalities as well. Okay, so that was the president. Then we have the vice president. Now, from India, there was one person that has become the first Indian to be the member of this FINA. Who is that person? What is the name of that person? The name is Virendra Nanavat. So he is the person that has become first Indian to be a member of the board of FINA. So I hope that this much is clear to you. Now, we have discussed about FINA. So I'm telling you that the headquarters of this FINA is in Switzerland. But can you tell me the exact location where this headquarters of FINA located in Switzerland? So this is your task that you have to mention in the comment section below. And this is the last question for today. What is the theme of World Ocean Day? First of all, this World Ocean Day is observed on June 8th. Remember the date. So out of the five options that you are seeing on your screens, the right answer is option D. The ocean, life and livelihoods is the theme for this year of this World Ocean Day. So I hope that you guys have enjoyed what I have taught you. And in case you have any query, then you can ask me in the comment section below. Thank you so much for watching the video.